Powdery mildew found its way into hop yards in Oregon in the summer of 1998, and that was pretty devastating at the time. The growers had no experience managing the disease, and so they weren't certain which varieties were susceptible, which ones were resistant or less susceptible, and there wasn't basic control measures in place. So 1998 was quite a difficult year for the Oregon hop industry because of powdery mildew.
And nobody really knew what to do. It started in Washington the year prior to it showing up in Oregon, or maybe 2 years prior to it showing up in Oregon. So we had a little heads up it was coming, but there still wasn't a lot known, and there wasn't a lot of registered chemistry to take care of the issue, and there was really zero cultural practice that anybody had any idea of what to do as far as, you know, culturally. So the first thing that everybody did was just started spraying everything, you know, regardless of whether you had the problem on your farm or not. USDA and Dr. Dave Gent started working with us, coming at it from I think all angles. I mean, probably basically the life cycle of the disease, how it spreads throughout the canopy, you know, how it was moving around the fields, when it was starting, really became a big focal point.
What we've learned about the disease cycle over time is that what's very important is the initial occurrence of disease in the spring, and it produces a structure called a flag shoot. And this is just a term for a hop shoot that emerges in spring, and it's colonized by the powdery mildew fungus. And so one of the foundational cultural practices that we've learned is quite important is how the growers prune in spring. And so they actually have a potential to eliminate those initial infections, those flag shoots, in spring with their pruning practice.
That practice is known as crowning, and it's most effective when it's done before the first flag shoots appear. In crowning, growers cut off the top inch or two of each plant's root crown, just below soil level.
What we see is that in Oregon specifically, the number of fungicide applications a grower makes and the efficacy of their program, entire disease control program, is largely dictated by how thoroughly they remove the disease very early in the season with that pruning practice, and or how near they are to sources of the disease where growers haven't done that.
It's important to be able to have look beyond our farm, because those nasty spores travel. And so we can do whatever, however we feel is the exact right thing to treat for the disease every year. But if our neighbors are not following suit, we need to know that. Because we could think that we're fully in a safe zone, but a neighboring spores could put us in danger again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Going back to the initial appearance of disease in the spring, this seems to be the real bottleneck in the life cycle of the pathogen where we can really affect it. And so the other part of this is trying to get growers to understand what fields are at risk very early in the spring for disease so that they can apply those control measures preventatively. And the more growers that adopt this and the more of those initial infections we can eliminate at the landscape level, the more we think we'll suppress disease industry-wide.
Well, I think if everybody was carried out a program of crowning, scratching, and burning, and everything, where there wouldn't be anything, I don't think we'd have mildew down here. I mean, that's my opinion. I think that it sounds pretty simplistic, but I don't think it's that hard to control.
The more buy-in that we have from growers on being preventative with some of these control measures and sharing data later, the more benefit everyone will see from it. And so this is scaling up to an area-wide management approach where we actually have communication amongst growers, information sharing, and hopefully coordinated management. Whether we can actually get to the point where we have 100% buy-in, I hope so. I'm not sure, because again, each individual grower has their own constraints and costs, and there's going to be some challenges, but I think we can do better than we are now, though, and I think over the next 5 years, I think we'll see that.
I think just the reality of the disease is going to pull people toward having to do it eventually. That's the way the ball's kind of rolling in that direction, but it's not going fast enough, in my opinion. Mm-hmm.